Thanks to Linode Cloud Computing for supporting this episode of SciShow. Go to linode.com/scishow to learn more and get a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. One of the biggest challenges in public health is preventing the rise of superbugs, relentless bacteria strains able to evade our attempts to destroy them. And as more infectious diseases build resistance to medicines that have historically been used to successfully fend them off, some strains are even able to defy multiple types of antibiotics. Antibiotic-resistant bacterial infections are one of the top 10 greatest threats to our health around the world, and the situation could get a lot worse. So, with a lot of our commonly used antibiotics becoming less effective against a wider range of bacteria, we need to look for other options, and fast. One way to develop more effective drugs is to turn to sources we've never used before. And that's where some of the world's most venomous snakes might just come in handy. Venomous snakes use their specialized fangs to inject a powerful concoction into their prey. This venom is a highly toxic mix of hundreds of molecules used to subdue a meal before swallowing it whole, as well as help digest it. But it turns out venom has powerful antimicrobial properties too. This might serve to protect the snakes from infection if their preferred prey carry parasites and bacteria that could otherwise harm them as they consume it. Over the years, numerous antimicrobial agents have been discovered in the venom for different species of snakes. And some of these components have now been isolated from venom and tested against common troublesome bacterial infections experienced by humans. For example, king cobra venom is shown to be effective against E. coli, as well as strains of Staphylococcus and Salmonella. There are two main ways we treat bacterial infections, either by stopping their growth or disrupting their cell membranes. In the case of snake venom, it appears numerous enzymes and certain protein fragments use the cell membrane approach to kill the unwanted microbes, releasing their internal fluids. Since snake venom is such a complex mix of molecules, this research is uncovering a broad selection of antimicrobial elements for potential applications such as medicine. But there are big differences in the composition and concentrations of proteins found between species. And that means not all venoms are alike in terms of antimicrobial abilities. In fact, different species might fight distinct microbes more effectively than others. For example, Western diamondback rattlesnake venom also works well against E. coli, but venom from a species of South American pit viper doesn't. So we may have our work cut out for us when it comes to figuring out what venoms, or more specifically which of their isolated components, to use against which bacteria. And there's another factor as well, actually converting those venoms into treatments. For the most part, research has focused on two families of snakes. One being Elapidae, which includes the cobras, mambas, and coral snakes, some of the most deadly snakes to humans. Studies have also centered around species from the Viperidae family, the vipers and rattlesnakes. But there's also Kalubrididae, a very large family of snakes. There are only a small number of venomous species found in this family, and even those that do produce toxins just don't have particularly potent venom, at least not to humans. Kalubrid snakes haven't been as well studied for their antimicrobial properties, but there could be big benefits to turning our attention toward them. For one, there may be more adverse side effects for humans when we're using compounds isolated from the more deadly snake families. So some researchers believe that studying Kalubrid venoms might actually clue us into treatments that are safer and better tolerated by humans. And while there's a lot of promise for tackling bacterial infections using properties from venom, we haven't gotten to the best part. We might be able to use it to fight off other microbes too. Venom tested from each of the three snake families have also been shown to exhibit antiparasitic properties. For example, certain venoms were effective against the parasite Leishmania. It causes leishmaniasis, a potentially deadly infection that can create skin sores and interfere with the function of internal organs. Finding new ways to fight off these types of parasites would benefit people around the world. All that said, there's still a ways to go before you'll be able to open your medicine cabinet and take your pick of snake venom-based treatments. New antibiotics are difficult to develop. There haven't been any approved for years now, and that's not for lack of trying. So despite all we now know about snake venom, it'll be difficult to turn it into something we can safely consume. For instance, the size of many of the molecules in venom makes them hard for us to manufacture. We'd have to find a way to efficiently synthesize them for use in medicines. We'll also need to find ways to make them more long-lasting, as well as find a form that could actually be taken up and used by the body so that they'd actually work in a pill or something similar. And maybe most importantly, we'd still need to figure out how these specific proteins can be used to affect unwanted microbes without hurting our tissues at the same time. Because it's snake venom. But the research is looking very promising, and one day we might just be able to thank a viper or rattlesnake for saving our lives. I think then we'll be feeling pretty guilty about the bad rap we've given them all these years. Thank you for watching this episode of SciShow. If you're streaming this video right now, that's one of the ways you could use Linode in your daily life. This episode of SciShow is supported by Linode. Linode Cloud Computing powers the internet and makes it possible to provide additional storage space, databases, analytics, and more to you or your company all over the internet. With cloud computing, everything is online when you need it. Linode's website is full of tutorials for how to use their services in innovative ways that you might not have even known you could do yourself, like hosting a business website, gaming server, or grading platform. To see all that Linode has to offer, click the link in the description or head to linode.com/scishow. That link gives you a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. Thank you to Linode for supporting this video.